All right, now there'll be Various Thoughts Volume 68. So let's get it going. The NFL Predictions Volume 30. I'm gonna get the NFC and AFC out of the way. For the NFC side, I have the New York Giants, San Francisco 49ers, Chicago Bears, Atlanta Falcons. Wild card teams, I have the Green Bay Packers and the Philadelphia Eagles. They will beat out Carolina Panthers. For the NFC title game, I have the Bears and 49ers, and Chicago will be going to the Super Bowl. As for the AFC side, I have the Kansas City Chiefs, New England Patriots, Houston Texans, and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Wild card teams, I have the San Diego Chargers and the Baltimore Ravens. I have the Houston Texans squaring off against New England Patriots for the right to go to the Super Bowl. And New England will win that AFC title game, represent the AFC side in Super Bowl 47 in New Orleans, Louisiana, and they will win it all over Chicago Bears and give Bill Belichick and Tom Brady their fourth Super Bowl ring. So there you have it. And top three coaches I have who are on the hot seat. I have Lovie Smith at number one, Rex Ryan for the New York Jets, number two, and North Turner, the San Diego Chargers, number three. But you know it's going to happen. They're going to underachieve, and he's still going to be there. That dude's like a cat, got nine lives or something. Dwight Howard trade for NBA. Does it put the LA Lakers a team to win it all? Not necessarily, no, because you still got the Miami Heat. I feel they got better, and the LA Lakers, they got worse, just a little bit, just a tab a bit, because you got two players with bad backs already. You got Steve Nash, who's about, what, 38, 39 years old, with a bad back. You got Dwight Howard. You know, he just came off with a back injury. Kobe Bryant, the way he keeps playing, he looks like he's going to be in a wheelchair. And, I mean, sure, they solved the point guard issues, but how long is going to last? And the bench, yeah, they got Antoine Jameson for 1 year, so that's good. Maybe, you know, Antoine Jameson can straighten out Meta World Peace. That's wishful thinking. So, there you go. Now, a little bit of NBA predictions. I have the Philadelphia 76ers versus the Miami Heat for the Eastern Conference Finals. And the Western Conference Finals, I have the Oklahoma City Thunder versus the LA Lakers. I got the Heat and Lakers. And the Heat will go back-to-back. NBA is very predictable. So predictable, you know what's going to happen. It's not NFL where it's unpredictable. It's just not. NBA is extremely predictable. People are talking about, you know, Dwight Howard, his indecision, dragging the Orlando Magic and the fans through the mud is far worse than what LeBron James did to the Cleveland Cavaliers front office management and owner Dan Gilbert, you know, put him on TV and put him on blast and everything. You know what? Both of them are worse in all accounts. Okay. Both of them are worse in their own ways. You know, as much as I'm not sold on Andrew Bynum, I feel that he's going to be a better center with the Philadelphia 76ers versus Dwight Howard for now the brand new Los Angeles Lakers. So, has anyone heard about Kobe Bryant's wife, Vanessa, going off saying, oh, I don't want to marry a guy that doesn't win championships every single year, yada, yada, yada. I'm like, oh, wow, this chick is crazy. Oh, so it's like that? It's like that all the time, huh, Vanessa Bryant? Okay. I mean, you can't be mad at her, but at the same time, she sounds like a super fan, if you ask me. So, that's all I'm gonna leave it there, right there, man. As for the Olympics, it was average. It was good. It was bad in between. People talking about Michael Phelps being the greatest Olympian ever for the simple fact that he won so many medals, including a bunch of gold medals. But I would have to say, Olympians like Jesse Owens, Usain Bolt, Carl Lewis, Michael Jordan, Mark Spitz, Bruce Jenner, everybody else. That's like saying Bill Russell is the greatest basketball player of all time because he won 11 championships. And we all know that's not true. Am I discounting Bill Russell? No, I'm not disrespecting him, but everyone's looking at like, oh, he's great. I never even seen him play. And that due to the fact that I wasn't born yet, so. Do I think he's the greatest Olympian swimmer of all time? Yes. Yes, he is. No one, I mean no swimmer in the Olympics will ever break Michael Phelps's medal records and all this kind of stuff. That ain't gonna happen. No way, no how. What was it? Judo, USA women's boxing team won a gold medal, so that's cool. That's awesome. Men, however, not so much. They came home without a medal, and that's really odd. 'Cause every Olympics, they win at least a medal, and the judges has to get better. I don't know how many times people are gonna continue to say it. I mean, it's just one bad decision after another. It's just sad all the way around that it's 2012 and they still can't get it right. USA women's basketball team doing their thing as usual. They should get more respect and people should stop discounting them. USA men's basketball team, yeah, they won and they beat Spain. That's cool in a gold medal match. It's amazing that the media can do a complete 360 after they turn on LeBron James and just label him as a choker. He's this, he's that, yada yada yada. That as soon as he win an NBA title, win a gold medal, oh my God, he's better than Michael Jordan. Always have, always will be, yada 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 yada. Okay, media, let's get something straight. LeBron James lost in the NBA Finals with the Cleveland Cavaliers against my hometown team, the San Antonio Spurs, of course, got swept, if my memory serves me correctly. And number two, with the Miami Heat, the first year, I think it was 2 years ago, they lost to who? Dallas Mavericks, which I predicted. I predicted that the Miami Heat will lose in the NBA Finals to a Western Conference opponent, but I picked the Lakers instead of the Mavericks. And LeBron James is 1-2 in the NBA Finals. So how can he be better than Michael Jordan? Please explain to me. Please. And one more thing. Michael Jordan never lost in the NBA Finals when he was with Chicago Bulls and never pushed to 7 games in the NBA Finals. So let's get that out of the way. Did he have bad games? Absolutely. But did he quit like LeBron James did? No. So, open, shut case. I don't know what John Sally is smoking, so. Oh, I'm gonna leave him off my top five. Greatest basketball players of all time. Okay. That's your opinion, but you've been smoking something. It ain't the good stuff. Now. And the thing that really boils my blood the most is that the media will sit there and make LeBron James as this sympathetic figure. Look at this guy. Look what he been through in all his entire career. I'm like, oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. The same LeBron James that acted like a moron, acting like a doofus. All the things he did, he brought up on himself. Stop it, media. This is why sports fans can't stand you. Just shut up. As for Gabby Douglas's hair, get over it, people. That goes you too, black community. Shut up. The very same people who are criticizing her are the very same people will defend celebrity athletes who act a fool. Oh, I don't know, Chad Johnson, Dez Bryant. Know those guys? I thought so. And last but not least, Penn State Nittany Lions football program. I feel bad for the players, past, present, now, and future, who want to play for that school, for that football program. They're going to suffer the consequences. 4-year postseason bowl ban, fine $60 million, 5-year probation, loss of scholarships over the next 4 or 5 years, and what else? Vacating 111 wins from Joe Paterno, 112 overall. The last win that he had was 1997 against the Wisconsin Badgers. I think people, the Penn State Nittany Lions and the fans and the alumni and students need to back down, be quiet, shut up, go away. The statue of Joe Paterno should be the very least of your worries, and Jerry Sandusky writing a book. That is disgusting. Totally disgusting. The man upstairs will deal with you when you die. You can bank on that. Don't let a sick dude like him run around molesting, sodomized, raping little boys, now men, for 14 years, and 4 men in charge, and everyone else who knew about the situation didn't do jack spit. Wow. Just wow. And with that, I'm throwing the peace sign. You know what to do. I'm out.